Hello friends, I am Prashant and welcome to this new vlog. Hello friends, and in this new exclusive vlog, I'm gonna make a portrait of a cat and I'm just trying to make it realistic. So keep watching till then. Hope the video is gonna be very interesting. So friends, if you're new to this channel and if you like my artwork, do not forget to press the bell icon, subscribe and share if you like. So as you know that I'm just trying to make it realistic and I have already indented the page and some of the areas I'm making indenting, and you will get a specific video on indenting in my channel. I will give the link in my description box. And this is the inkless pen and I'm just trying to make indenting and trying to indent the paper. I'm just trying to zoom out, you can see the texture. And after indenting you can get such texture, and you have to indent the subject as per the reference. Hope the video is gonna be very interesting. Keep watching. So this is the inkless pen and I'm starting with eye section. As you can see, I'm using charcoal, and I will suggest all the beginners and artists to use charcoal. And once you will use charcoal, obviously try to use the blending brush as a blender. So as you can see, I'm just trying to make the dark sections. And after applying every layer, you have to apply blending brush to make it blend. And generally for the hyper-realistic portrait, I use Tombow mainly for sophisticated areas. This is my mechanical eraser, as you can see. I'm just trying to get the highlights on the eye section, and I'm also using Devil Eraser, which is very much helpful. So this is the way you can draw, and every artist's own specific styles, and you will also generate within yourself such specific styles. You can follow those styles. I generally do in this way. That's why I'm showing. Hope you will like this way and you can try. So as you can see, the eye section is completed a bit. I'm just trying to draw the far section, mainly the texture of the skins, mainly the fars, some of the hairs upon the head. And firstly, try to go for the dark areas. Try to emphasize the dark areas mainly. And after every layer, not forget to blend it to get a realistic texture. And your texture will come out automatically because the paper is already been indented. So whenever you are going to draw any kind of tiger or bear or such creature who is related to fur or full of hairs, obviously indent the paper at first, then try to apply your charcoal on whatever the medium you want to apply. Even it can be pencil, it can be graphite, whatever you want, but indent the page as per your reference, then try to apply these mediums actually. So these are some of the areas, but after every layer I will use blending brush, and for charcoal do not use any other blending tools because charcoal can be smudged easily. So use blending brush, that will give a great texture as you can see in this video as well. So it's easily getting smudged, so you can use, and you can use some of these techniques as well. These are some of the hair section. So this is the way you can follow. And if you like my work, you can get me on Insta in Prashant Majumdar @4. So friends, as you can see, it's looking quite realistic, but we have to make it realistic as much as possible from our end. And I'm using medium charcoal, the medium one, and this area will not be dark much, and that's why I'm just using medium one. But at the end of the layer, we have to blend it, and what I'm doing. So you can follow my Insta in this Prashant Majumdar 4@. So this is how I am just trying to make it realistic. As you can see, the texture is coming automatically because the paper is already been indented. And I always prefer to highlight the dark areas at first. And what I am doing
just trying to follow. These are some of the dark areas and I'm just trying to chalk it out. As per the reference, this will be dark a bit. So these are semi-dark areas as I am trying to make it. These areas will be quite dark and some of the areas I have already chalked out. So these areas will be the dark areas and now I am going to apply the medium charcoal in these areas. And there are so many areas which will get the texture of our section. But this is quite looking scattered areas, but after blending the texture will come out. So as you can see, this is getting quite realistic as per every step. So I'm just trying to blend it, and we have to use erasers as well to get a realistic texture. So I'm using Tombow mechanical eraser. I will give the link where you need to buy Tombow. If you want, you can buy from that link. So this is how I'm trying to making it realistic. So now I'm going for background. This is the background actually. So I'm just trying to apply some soft chalk and making the background. Very light, and that's why I'm just trying to apply the dark background. That's why I'm using soft chalk. So as you can see, the picture is quite nice. This is how you can try when the subject will be not much dark, then the background needs to be dark. For that, we haven't get a look of it.
So friends, thanks for watching, keep practicing, keep improving and support the channel.